come for our special business. Amen? Amen. We come up to the high point of service, as we call preaching time. Amen. We have a pastor can preach and will preach. Filled with the Holy Ghost. Sanctified. He's filled. Amen. He knows how to preach. Spirit, get on him. Well, I know he don't have his way today. I want to let you know I'm on your side. Amen. Amen. I like to present to some and introduce to others. Amen. The proud and humble pastor. Amen. Of the Union Spring Missionary Baptist Church. Amen. As he come in his own way. Amen. Let us elevate our right hand and say, Pastor Jacob, preach the word. Pastor Jacob, preach, 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 preach the word. As he come in his own way, ladies and gentlemen, I give you Pastor Jacob.
Let's give our mothers another hand clap of praise. Amen. We deserve it. Let's give the Lord another hand clap of praise. Again, we want to wish you all a very, very happy Mother's Day. We pray that your day is a blessed day. Many words have been said in your honor today. Amen. We're going to try to say just a few more. At the same time, give all of us some encouragement in the Lord. Amen. Amen. So first we give honor and glory to our Heavenly Father. Amen. To my brother, the minister, Reverend Marshall. Mr. Marshall. My wife, too. I'll say all of the mothers first. Amen. To our deacons and deaconesses, trustees, trustee wives, to all of you. Amen. Whether you be inside, whether you be outside on 87.9, or whether you be online later on social media. Amen. And to Sister Jessie, thank God for you. Amen. I want to invite you to Proverbs chapter number 3. I want to begin with the very last words my grandmother told me while she had the strength to speak. Proverbs chapter 3, beginning at verse 5. Proverbs chapter 3, beginning at verse 5. I want to ask for just a little bit of patience in reading this morning. I want to read verses 5 through 20. But I'll read quick. Proverbs 3, chapter 5. Best amen. Need me to wait? Just holler wait. I'll wait. We'll get you to them turnip greens and ribs and whatever else y'all eat in no time. Cabbage and fat back.
All that good stuff.
That's right. Proverbs chapter number 3. Beginning at verse number 5. Amen. I believe we got it. It reads, trust in the Lord with all thine heart.
Yeah.
Lean not unto thine own understanding.
Uh-huh.
All thy ways acknowledge him.
Uh-huh.
And he shall direct thy paths.
Yeah.
Be not wise in thine own eyes.
Uh-huh.
Fear the Lord and depart from evil.
Uh-huh.
It shall be health to thy navel.
Uh-huh.
Marrow to thy bones.
Yeah.
Honor the Lord with thy substance.
Uh-huh.
And with the first fruits of all thine increase.
Mm-hmm.
So shall thy barns be filled with plenty.
Yeah.
Thy presses shall burst out with new wine.
Yeah.
Did you know that? My son, despise not the chastening of the Lord,
mm-hmm.
neither be weary of his correction.
Yeah.
For whom the Lord loveth, he corrected.
That's right.
Even
That's
as a father, the son in whom he delighted.
Uh-huh.
Happy is the man that findeth wisdom and the man that getteth understanding.
Yeah.
For the merchandise of it is better than the merchandise of silver.
Amen.
And the gain thereof than fine gold. I slowed down here because this is where I want to pay attention to. She is more precious, verse 15, than rubies.
Uh-huh.
And all the things thou canst desire are not to be compared unto her.
Yeah.
Length of days is in her right hand, and in her left hand riches and honor.
Uh-huh.
Her ways are ways of pleasantness.
Uh-huh.
And all her paths are peace. She is a tree of life to them that lay hold upon her. And happy is everyone that retaineth her.
Amen.
The Lord by wisdom hath founded the earth. By understanding hath he established the heavens.
Yeah.
By his knowledge the depths are broken up. And the clouds drop down the dew.
Yeah.
Thank you for honoring the word of God, whether you stand or sit. Thank you for giving the word your attention.
Amen.
Amen. If I could take a few moments of your time, I want to deal with the topic, what Mama Nam taught us. I'm from Talladega, and I didn't have English education. Amen, but I'm going to talk like we talk. What Mama Nam taught us. Amen. When I say Mama Nam, I'm including Grandma, Big Mom, Me Mom. I'm including daddy, granddaddy as well, but amen, we want to give attention to the mothers today, amen, so we don't want to get jealous, men, amen, we're going to let them have their day, but what Mama Nam taught us, amen, just a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the opportunity to preach your word and not my opinion. Thank you for your word. Father, I pray, Lord, that through your word that you would give life in the house this morning. Father God, I thank you for our mothers. Thank you for what they have instilled in us. Father, I ask that you would just grant them grace and favor today, Father God, that you would bless not only their day, but that you would add special blessings to their life, Father God. In Jesus' name we thank you and we do pray. Amen. Amen. With Mama Nam taught us. According to crimegrade.org, 89% of cities in America are considered safer than Talladega, Alabama. 89% of the cities of America are safer than Talladega, Alabama. Those that were in Bible study, I told you we're going to speak to this today.
Yeah.
Recently, our community has mourned the losses of multiple individuals in their teens and early 20s. The youngest I've heard was 14 years old. It's not just in Talladega.
That's right.
Violence is all over our country. I find myself, my brothers and sisters, praying and wondering why our young people seem so much further away from the teaching that we were brought up in. So much further away from the church and from the values that my generation ought to appreciate because we are who we are because of what Mama Nam taught us. It seems like we laid aside what Mama Nam taught us and we think we got a better way. What Mama Nam gave us was what made us rich before we even knew what money was.
Yes, sir.
As I prayed, even shed tears over the condition of our community, these scriptures hit me. I want to bring out a few things from the scriptures to help us, and then I want to encourage our mothers today. First thing that I want to give you from the text is value wisdom over money.
Yeah.
That's what mama them taught me. That's what mama them taught us. Value wisdom over money. We've gotten to the point where we have access to more money these days, and we raise our children with what we can buy rather than what we can teach. That's the reason why so many of my children are so spoiled. That's the reason why they're after riches, they're after money, and they'll do anything in their power to get it, because we made them value money over what mama and them taught us.
Yes, sir.
We think because we can give our children so much more than our parents God gave us, that we're better parents than they are. But you ain't no better parent if you don't pass down what made you who you are today. Money don't make the man. You teach the man to make the money, but money don't make nobody. Value wisdom over money, over riches, over gain. Begins telling us to trust in the Lord with all of your heart, my grandmama told me. Lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path. Why is that important? Because when we're young, we're foolish. We don't have wisdom. We don't understand what we need. We don't know where we're going. All we know is what we want for ourselves. And we think we know better than our parents because we know what we want for myself. We think we got a little bit more education than our parents. And so we get the big head, and we think we all have been there.
Yeah.
Every generation thought they knew better than their parents did. And we found out what mama them told us was the truth.
Yeah.
We really don't understand. If you lean to your own understanding, you're going to let yourself down. Let me go on here and tell you the truth right now, young
That's
folks.
Right. That's right. That's right.
You don't know
what
you think you know. Just because you got electronic devices doesn't mean you're smarter than anybody else. I try to be smarter than my children. I try to stay up on technology. They don't even know what I know. Because I want to make sure I stay far ahead of them, because I want to see you coming. You ain't going to pull a wool over on my eyes. See, what mama them tried to teach us was from the perspective that they've been there. They lived through some things. They had gained some wisdom. They knew where we were going. They knew where we were trying to go. And they were trying to keep us from going there. Because heartache and heartbreak is something that will take somebody out if you're not strong enough to handle it. But there's somebody that knows more than they know. Trust in the Lord. And lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge the Lord, and let the Lord direct your path. My grandmother was trying to tell me you can always trust God, because God loves you. God knows everything. He's from everlasting to everlasting. That scripture began to open up to me the more I got older. Back then I wasn't ready to receive it, but now I can't let the scripture go. God knows it all. He is the source of wisdom. And what mama them told us is to hold on to it. That he'll never leave you nor forsake you. He'll never put you in harm's way just to hurt you. If God puts you in the way of harm, it's to help you. It's because some people need to drop off in your life. Some things need to drop off in your life. God will never put you in the way of being crushed for no reason. You can trust him. But value wisdom over money. Let me get to this. Let me drop down to verse number 14 and 15.
All right.
That the merchandise of wisdom is better than the merchandise of silver, and the gain thereof than fine gold.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Now, we're very familiar with silver and gold.
Yes, sir.
Matter of fact, silver doesn't mean as much to us as gold does.
Uh-huh.
But Solomon takes it a step further.
Yeah.
Solomon says that wisdom not only is more valuable than silver and gold, but he says she is more precious than rubies.
Yes.
I need you to understand how valuable rubies are. Because the average person, Brother Derek, doesn't buy you a ruby ring to propose to you. See, we like diamonds. Because diamonds are clear. Diamonds shine bright. When the light hit them, diamonds are something else. But can I tell you, the sunrise ruby is more valuable than diamonds? Can I tell you that rubies are the rarest gem that you'll ever find on the earth? So when Solomon says that wisdom is more precious, Sister Valerie, than rubies, what Solomon is saying is that wisdom is more valuable, it's more precious, it's more rare, it's to be more coveted, it's to be more desired than the most rare thing you find on earth. Forget silver and gold. He took it to the step where there is a gem that the average person can't buy. Rubies are worth 200 times more than gold. 200 times more than gold. This is the reason why when you go searching for rubies, most of the time you find lab-created rubies. Because when you run up on the real deal, you're going to shell out some money.
Yeah, yeah.
Diamonds, because they're more valued in the perception of the public, are actually priced higher. But rubies are more rare, more precious. When you find a ruby, hold on to it. I need you to remember I made that statement because I'm going to make another point about that later on. When you find a ruby, hold on.
To
it. But what Solomon says is that wisdom is more valuable than the ruby that's worth 200 times more than gold. Value wisdom over even rubies. Value wisdom over money. But then he says, value wisdom over all the things that thou can desire. So you can't compare anything to it. That's the reason why I said what mama them taught us made us richer than we ever could have been. It made us rich before we even knew what money was. Because wisdom, my second point, lengthens your days. Wisdom lengthens your days. See, you can die chasing money if you don't have wisdom.
That's right.
People who have money, who don't have wisdom, will lose money. But wisdom will add to your pocket and add to your days on earth. I've seen people with wisdom make $30,000 a year and always have money.
That's right.
And when I was out there foolish, making almost $60,000 a year, I never had money. I wasn't rich, but I had more than enough. I was foolish because I didn't adhere to what mama them was trying to teach. Wisdom will lengthen your days. Back up to number 8. It shall be health to your navel, marrow to your bones. Then verse number 10, if you honor the Lord, then your barns will be filled with plenty. Your presses shall burst out with new wine. Amen. Happy is the one that findeth wisdom and the one that gets understanding. But down to 16, length of days is in her right hand. And her left hand riches and honor. Her ways are ways of pleasantness,
all her past of peace, but verse 18, she is a tree of life to them that lay hold upon her. And happy is everyone that retaineth her. This is why the first commandment with promise is to honor the, your father and your mother. That it may be well with thee. That your days may be lengthened on the earth. Because if father and mother are trying to teach you with godly wisdom, they're trying to teach you to live. They're trying to teach you to succeed. They're trying to teach you not to go to jail. Not to end up with the wrong man. Not to end up with the wrong woman. They're trying to teach you how to keep some money in your pocket. They're trying to teach you how to build your credit up. They're trying to teach you godly wisdom that will prolong your life. But if you don't value what mother and father are trying to teach you, you go out there your own way, you're not going to live long. Godly wisdom is to preserve you. It's to keep you. We all in here from the country. I don't believe we got no city slickers in here. I lived in the city. But I grew up in the country. So I believe all of us know what preserves are. I believe somebody might have ate something this morning with a hot biscuit. But when you preserve fruit, Lord have mercy, I've seen fruit sit on top of the cabinet for 5+ years. But if you leave it out, it's gonna be dead within days. And that preserve you. Child might look at it and say, that from 2015, that stuff ain't right. But when they open it up, it tastes just as fresh as it was when you made it. Talk about preserving you. If you want to live, grab a hold to wisdom. Grab a hold of what Mama Nim tried to teach us. Hallelujah, to have a relationship with the Lord. To never forsake the Lord, to respect your elders, have some manners, to clean up your room, to present yourself like you somebody, to open your mouth and speak like you ain't got nothing in your mouth. Mom and them tried to preserve our lives so that when we grew up and got out there in the world, we might find ourselves doing all right for ourselves. We're talking about. Just because they didn't have money didn't mean they didn't have wisdom. Just because they didn't have a big house didn't mean they didn't have everything that you needed. You're trying to lengthen your days. Thirdly, the Lord shows us what wisdom is. As I hurry to the close, it says in verse number 19, the Lord by wisdom hath founded the earth.
All right.
By understanding hath he established the heaven.
Yeah.
By his knowledge, what he's saying when he says the depths are broken up, he divided the waters.
Uh-huh. Yes,
it is. Hallelujah. Because in the beginning, the Spirit of God hovered over the water.
Uh-huh.
But he called forth the land.
Yeah.
And clouds dropped down. The dew. What does that say to us? That when God created the heavens and the earth, he assigned purpose to everything he created. There was nothing that God made that did not have a purpose, even the gnats and mosquitoes. I know we hate them, especially when we come down to certain parts of the country. I don't know why God made these things. But them little birds need to eat too. And they catch them in midair. God gave purpose to everything that he made. So I need you to hear this. Let me give you another definition of what wisdom is. Wisdom is not just having knowledge. It's not just knowing how to apply knowledge, but wisdom is the application of knowledge for its purpose. Wisdom is the application of knowledge for its purpose. Because the Lord shows us what wisdom is through creation. The Lord has he's all knowing, right? He's omniscient. So when the omniscient God created everything, he assigned his purpose. So if we are going to walk with the wisdom of God, then we got to walk applying the knowledge that we have for its purpose that it was designed. When it comes to you and I, brothers and sisters, when it comes to you, mothers, God has a purpose for you. And God's purpose is never to snuff you out.
That's right.
God knows how to get you to that place called expected end.
Yeah.
He even though God, he spoke this to Jeremiah and to Judah when they were in times of trouble.
Yeah.
Right? For I know the plan that I have for you.
Yeah.
I know the thoughts that I have towards you.
Yeah.
Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. I'm paraphrasing. Thoughts of good and not of evil. To give you a hope and a future and an expected end. When God spoke, he's trying to tell us that I know you're going through some things, but don't despise my correction, because I'm trying to get you to that place called expected end. That's what Mama and them were trying to do for us. They were trying to get us to that place called expected end. Don't despise me when I whoop you with these switches, because I'm trying to make sure you hate that behavior that I'm trying to correct you from. Don't despise me when I take these things from you, because I'm trying to make you respect me, and I'm trying to make you respect your elders and learn how you're supposed to behave. Don't hate me when I punish you, because all I'm trying to do is get you to where I expect you to be. That's godly wisdom. That's godly wisdom. God's wisdom assigned purpose to his creation. So what the mother who lead what God's wisdom does for their procreation, for their children, hallelujah, they try to instill some things to get them to that place called expected end. Mama them taught me to speak clearly. I'm here preaching today. I ain't mumbling no more. Expect it in. Mama told her to stand up straight and don't slouch. Walk and swing your hand. Walk like you're going somewhere. Guess what happened when I adhered to what Mama them taught me? Somebody paid attention and said, you deserve to be in a position, because I like the way you carry yourself. Talking about expecting me. Hallelujah. Mama them taught this man how to get in the kitchen and learn how to cook a little bit. Now, this man got up. I ain't gonna pat myself on the back, but when it's time, this man can throw down. Let me just say that. Mama said she might marry somebody that can't cook. I thank God she taught me how to live on my own. Some of them taught us how to love the Lord. Brought us to church. Taught us at home. Read from the family Bible story book. What did that do for me? Train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he would not depart from it. I got to a place where even though I was living my life out there, I heard those words that were embedded in my heart. And one day when I was sincere, when I was ready to move on, I heard what Mama them tried to teach me about having a relationship with God. And hallelujah, I repented and came to the Lord, and he saved me before it was too late. Expected in. Mama and them didn't try to hurt us. And I know, and I pray for those who have abusive mothers I can't stand the thought, but I don't want to give that no attention this morning.
Yeah.
I want to give praise to the mothers who raised their children on purpose. Who raised their children with an expected end in mind. Who didn't mind if our children didn't like us for a season. Because one day you're going to appreciate me and you're going to love me for saving your life. We need more mothers like that. Who instead of just wanting to give your children what they want, because what they want is foolishness. What they want is a fast life. What they want is a sensation. What they want is to look good in front of friends. But I thank God for mothers who don't raise their children to give them what they want, but to give them an expected end. In my closing, let's not keep it too long. I told you that wisdom was more precious than rubies. And I told you how valuable rubies are. The most rare gem you'll find on the entire planet. And I told you that when you find a ruby, hold on to it. There's another ruby that I want to close out with. Another scripture that says that this particular thing is more precious than rubies. Deacon Hunter read it this morning in Proverbs 31. Proverbs 31, King Lemuel's mother is speaking to him. And she tells him about two ladies. She tells him about the one that takes away from you and the one that gives to you. She tells him that in verse number 10, that a virtuous woman, her price is far above rubies. When you find a virtuous woman, hold on to her, because she's better to you than rubies are. He read the scripture to you, but I want to paraphrase it as I close. He tells us about this woman that is more valuable than rubies, that her husband trusts her. That she puts her hands to work to help provide for home. That she is the glue of the family. That she helps those who are in need. That she's always prepared. That she adds to her husband's value. That she is a wise woman. That her children and her husband are blessed by them and call her blessed. When you find a virtuous woman, hang on to her. Because she's more pricey and she's more rare than a ruby is. Thank God for your virtuous woman. Thank God for mama them that tried to teach us right. Thank God for mama them that tried to tell us about having a relationship with Jesus Christ. Thank God for all of you virtuous women in the house today. Because you're more rare than a ruby is. Everybody else out there doing their own thing. But you remain virtuous. Hallelujah. Thank God for you. I done hollered at you a little bit. Thank God. Somebody loved me enough to teach me. Thank God that he gave me the grace that when I was out there in the world on my own, that he didn't take me before I really got saved. I got baptized at 13. But I got saved when I got grown. I got baptized because my friends went to the altar with me. But mama and them told me I need to know the Lord for myself. Maybe somebody in here, maybe somebody outside, maybe someone listening online who does not know the Lord. And now you remember what mama, what big mama, me mama, whatever you want to call it, tried to tell you. Trying to save your life. You don't know Jesus. You're dead. I hate for it to sound cold, but it's the truth. You say, well, I'm still moving around. Cut a branch off the tree. Pastor Howard Story Jr. said that when it falls to the ground, it's still green too. But it's not attached to its source of life. You're dead and out. But the scripture says that all become alive in Jesus Christ. Thank God mama and them told me about Jesus. You can be saved. If you want to know how, Romans 10, 9 and 10 says that thou wilt confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus. Yes. Believe in your heart God has raised him from the dead. Yes. Thou shalt be saved. Yes. That's the promise of God. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. He explains why something that sounds so simple can be so effective. With the heart man believes unto righteousness. Yes. And with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. If that's you and you're ready to take hold of what mama them tried to tell you, do it now. The doors of the church are open. Maybe here you just need prayer. I invite you, if you're here, to lift your hand. If you want to stand, you can stand, but lift your hands. We'll acknowledge you in prayer. If you're outside, honk your horn. If you're online, just come and pray. Amen. 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 And it may be that the Spirit is leading you to this ministry. I want to let you know that you are just as important as I am to this ministry. And our arms are always welcome. Welcoming you in. Let us pray. Most Heavenly Father, we thank you for your word today. Thank you, Lord, for what mama them taught us. Thank you that somebody cared enough to introduce us to you. Thank you for virtue, for wisdom. Thank you for the grace of the mothers that went on before us and how they carried themselves before us. Lord, I miss them, but I'm thankful for them because they laid out a pathway for us to walk in. Thank you for their examples, Lord. Father God, we come praying, Lord, that someone was encouraged through your word today, and that young mothers are encouraged, Father God, to value wisdom over what money can buy. Because Lord, what money can buy will pass away, but what wisdom gives is long life. By wisdom we come to know you, and we receive eternal life. Father God, we thank you for our mothers. Again, we pray a special blessing over each and every one of them in this house. Let your love, Lord God, just lift them up today. Let them know how special they are, Father God. Let them know how appreciated they are. And let them know they were made in your image too. This ain't a man's world, this is your world. Father God, we thank you for Jesus. How he died and rose again. That we might have a right to the tree of life. Because he did so, I even have this privilege to speak to you. So Lord, we thank you. Lord, the hands that have been lifted, the hearts that have been lifted without the hands. Father, we acknowledge each and every one of them in prayer. Lord, I ask that you search this house. If there's any lack, I ask that you fill it. Father, whatever it is, whether it be healing, finances, rest, a peace of mind, comfort, whatever it may be, Lord, you are able to supply. Father, I ask, Lord, now that you answer every prayer that's being lifted up in this house today. Father, I ask, Lord, that you touch someone who doesn't know you, that this word may penetrate their heart and they may grab a hold of you, come to know about your love. And Father God, as we get ready to go to our various destination, Father, we ask for your safe traveling grace for those that are traveling near and those that are traveling far. Lord, you brought them in safely. I ask, Lord, that you send them out safe. That their vehicles be a sanctuary where they enjoy your presence. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we glorify you. Now, Lord, we lift up the little family. Praying, Father God, that you would strengthen them, Lord God, today. Today may be hard for them, but Father, give them your grace. That they'll make it through. Now may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the sweet communion of his Holy Spirit, rest, rule, and abound in each one of us from this time and forevermore. Let us all say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Happy Mother's Day, and God bless you this day and this week. We love you all.